Today we're going to show you how to install a drip-line irrigation system on a foundation planting. This is the most efficient way to water a landscaped foundation area. A drip-line irrigation system eliminates the typical problems associated with sprinkler systems, such as runoff, overspray, evaporation, and wind drift, all of which can damage your home. Let's get started. Before starting any kind of digging, be sure you know what's underneath the areas to be dug up. In most areas, calling 811 will get you to the right folks who can come out and mark the location of utility lines on your property, as shown in this clip. You can also call the local utility to have them come out. Be sure to call cable, water sewer storm, gas, phone, and electric. Now that you know where to safely dig, you're going to need a few tools. For this particular installation, we need the following: 100-foot tape measure, shovel, pipe cutter, 100 feet of Duraflow CV tubing with 0.6 gallon per hour emitters and 12-inch spacing, tees, elbows, and couplers. The amount will vary for every installation. 2 end plugs. We recommend the Agrifim Smart Lock end plugs. In order to determine your flow rate and spacing, you need to take the following steps. Firstly, you need to call your local location services hotline to have utility lines marked. You want to ensure that you don't disturb these lines during installation. Next, you'll need to take a soil sample from the installation area in order to figure out your soil type. The type of soil will help determine the emitter flow rate. Click here for more information about determining your soil type. Third, you have to measure the size of the turf grass area to be watered. This will help you determine how much dripper line is required for the job. Lastly, you have to examine the water supply. This will help you figure out two things: your water flow rate in gallons per minute, and the pressure available for the installation. For more information on how to determine your flow rate and pressure, click here. In this particular residence, the soil type was determined to be clay loam. The size of the planting area was 150 square feet, and the flow and pressure of the water source was 25 gallons per minute at 80 psi. The dripline emitter flow rate, spacing, and lateral spacing is determined based on your soil type. This residence has clay loam soil. Using this chart, it was determined to use 0.6 gallon per hour emitters spaced at 12 inches with a lateral spacing of 18 inches. To determine the total feet of tubing necessary, we'll use this equation. Take the area of your foundation planting and multiply it by 12 inches. Then you take that number and divide it by the lateral spacing to get the total feet of tubing. For this residence, the area of the foundation planting is 150 square feet, and the lateral spacing in inches is 18, which equals 100 total feet of tubing. Next, we need to calculate zone flow. Zone flow is used in conjunction with your water source capability to help size your irrigation valve, drip filter, and regulator. Total zone flow equals the total feet of tubing times the flow per 100 feet divided by 100. To figure out your flow per 100 feet, reference this chart. For this example, the flow is based on 0.6 gallons per hour and 12-inch spacing, which equals 1.0 gallon per minute. The total zone flow for this particular residence is 100 feet multiplied by 1 gallon per minute divided by 100 feet, which is 1 gallon per minute. Based on this residence's available drip zone flow of 5 gallons per minute, it was determined it was possible to add this dripper line. Use the coupler to connect to your supply tubing. In this example, we used the Agrifim Smart Lock coupler. The Agrifim Smart Lock fittings allow you to connect to any half-inch tubing measuring 16 to 18 millimeters diameter. From the supply location, maneuver the Agrifim Duraflow CV throughout the planting area. Make sure to cover both sides of each plant with the tubing so the plants receive even watering. At the end of the tubing, use the end plugs to cap off the lines. These fittings also provide an easy way to flush your dripper line system. Flush the zone by opening the end plugs and turning the system on for 1 to 2 minutes until clear water is flowing from the flush points. Turn the system off and reinstall the end plug caps. Your system is now ready to operate. Select your desired ground cover mulch and place a 2 to 3 inch layer uniformly over the planting area. So there you have it, a simple and easy way to add drip irrigation to a newly installed landscape area. Drip irrigation can save you both time and money, and also give you the highest efficiency possible for your landscape irrigation. This particular installation shows how effective Dripline can be in watering an irregularly shaped planting area. Its slow, targeted application of water virtually eliminates the typical problem of runoff and can be made to work in all soil types. In addition, it applies water directly to the plant's roots, resulting in the healthiest, best-looking plants possible. For more information on this and other AgriFim drip irrigation products, check out our other videos.
For more than 30 years, NDS has been a leader in water management solutions for the residential and commercial markets. For more information on our other drip irrigation solutions and special offers, go to ndspro.com.